Business needs to make data-driven decisions with quality-improved process through data analytics and machine learning. Your team are often tasked with building complex, time-consuming, and cumbersome data pipeline in order to collect data from various data sources, both internally and externally, process them, and make the trusted data available for various business units quickly and securely. Hello, everyone. This is Ronnie Deng. I'm Senior Data Architect and Builder at AWS Professional Service. I work closely with our customers to help them design data architecture and build data pipelines in order to accelerate their data analytics and the machine learning journey. In the next 15 minutes, I will show you how you can simplify the builder experience with no-code, low-code data pipelines using Amazon Redshift. I will use a sample database ticket to illustrate how the data pipelines can be built using Amazon Redshift, three existing capabilities, and the three new features announced during reInvent 2022. Let's look at a common use case. On the right is the data consumptions layer. People from various business units are waiting for data to be available so that they use different tools to analyze them, draw insight, and take actions. On the left side, data coming from different sources, for example, operational databases, data lake, streaming data. In the middle, we have a complex data pipeline that we need to build to ingest, process, service data to the data consumers using Amazon Redshift. First, let me talk through three existing features Redshift is currently offering out of many others. In this scenario, data analysts already have access to three datasets in Redshift. They want to build a dashboard to show the number of events for each location, but found the event table doesn't have venue details information. The data team has venue dataset in Data Lake built on top of Amazon S3. Redshift federated queries allows you to query and analyze data across data warehouse, data lake, and the operational database without data movement. In this scenario, so that they can just run two SQL statements, create external schema from data catalog database, have venue datasets, grant permission to the role where the data analyst belongs to. After the statements run successfully, venue data will become available to data analysts right away. Once data analysts have access to the venue dataset in Redshift, they can join three existing tables, venue data in S3, to get the final result they need for the dashboard. If a scenario involves large tables, complex queries, processing these queries can be very expensive. Materialized views in Amazon Redshift provide a way to address this issue. A materialized view contains a pre-computed result set based on a SQL query over one or more base tables. You can issue select statements to query a materialized view in the same way as you query other tables of view. In this scenario, instead of running query directly and drawing table on the fly every time from dashboard, data team can create a materialized view and make the view available to data analysts and the dashboard. They can config to refresh the materialized view automatically or manually based on each use case. So next, data scientist team also need to access data. The way how data scientists access data used data is different from business analyst or data analyst. For example, data scientists may only need to retrain the model every 6 months. They need 10 years of historical data. They need specific storage and the computation resource for that specific period of time. Data sharing builds on Amazon Redshift RA3 managed storage, which decouples the storage and the compute, allowing each of them to scale independently. With data sharing, workloads accessing shared data are isolated from each other. In this scenario, we can set up existing cluster as producer cluster or ETL cluster, and set up Amazon Redshift serverless as a data science cluster. Queries against shared data run on data science cluster and read data from the Amazon Redshift managed storage layer directly without impacting the performance of the ETL cluster. On the producer side, we create the data share, add schema and the tables to be shared, grant permission to the customer namespace. Next, I will talk about three new features currently in public preview. In this scenario, sales data is being extracted from source operational database and stored into corresponding S3 bucket. Since sales data reflect the fact they're immutable, data team needs to make daily dataset available without modification. In the past, they have to make a data pipeline with multiple steps, coordinate the schedule with data extraction on source system, identify the data landed in S3, and copy to Redshift. Amazon Redshift autocopy preview features allow SQL users easily automate data ingestion from Amazon S3 to Amazon Redshift with a simple SQL command. Copy statements are triggered and start loading data when Amazon Redshift autocopy detects new files in the specified Amazon S3 path. This also ensures end user have the latest data available in Amazon Redshift shortly after source data is available. Next, in this scenario, we need to handle dataset continuous ingestion by having the records of insert, update, or deletion. Traditionally, this can only be achieved by using insert, update, or delete statement separately. Now, use the preview feature of merge, you can conditionally merge records from a source table into a target table. Lastly, but not least, this is very common in our customers. We have data available in the data warehouse, which data science requires. In this case, ETL cluster. However, it often took very long time to make those data available as data set have sensitive information that data scientists and the team doesn't need or approval have access. But other teams request them for their data day-to-day operations. Normally, data team has to build a specific data pipeline to remove those sensitive data and make data available. Now you can use Redshift dynamic data masking in preview to protect sensitive data in your data warehouse. Manipulate how Amazon Redshift shows sensitive data to the user at query time without transforming it in the database. Control access to data through masking policy that apply customer obfuscation rules to a given user or role. For the time allowed, I will demonstrate some of those features next. Now let me demonstrate how autocopy works. First, we will create a sales table in Redshift. We verify the total count is zero. We load the 5 months data from F3. And then we created the copy job and set the load mode as auto. Here we already have set up a role-based access control in Redshift to simplify the permission management and grant the permission to take read-only role. We check the total count again, and now the number is 69K. We assign the ticket read-only role to QuickSight read-only user so that business analysts can access data through QuickSight. So business analysts create a dashboard in QuickSight. We can see 5 months sales data now show in dashboard. We also go to the system table to check if a copy job has been set up properly. We check the copy job commit table to see the data loading details. In S3, source system has extract more data and put in S3 bucket. We check the total row count again. Now the number is 85K. In QuickSight, we already set the dataset query mode as a direct query. We open the dashboard again. Now we can see the June data has been added. Since the setup is for one-time historical load, after data loading, we can just drop the copy job. Now let's look at how you can use merge command combination with the federated query and the materials view. Business analyst from marketing team is doing an event planning. They're trying to create a field dashboard in QuickSight. Notice that the venue table has no country code, so they cannot create a map in the dashboard. Data team create a state country mapping table. Load the data from S3 to Redshift. They check the result and notice several records is not right. And then they notice the other table also have the same issue. So they fix the code and put the data back to the S3. They check the data and then verify the result in Athena. Since this has been a one-time load, they decide to use a federated query to create an external schema, grant the permission, and then check that they can read the data from Redshift. They use the merge command to merge the record from S3 with the mapping table, check the result. They use the same approach to fix the state issue as well and verify the final table. Everything looks good. Then they created the materials view for venue by adding country field. They also create a materials view to join the event table with the catalog table and the venue. Verify the result. And grant the permission to ticket role again. Now, data analyst or business analyst can create the dashboard in QuickSight, showing the result, what's the event, by state, and the event sees number by state as well. So happy to be here and spend the last 15 minutes to talk through six features I picked for you so you can use to build your data pipeline with Redshift. Data ingestion. Use federated query to make data available without data movement. Using preview feature of auto-copy for continuous data ingestion. On the processing side, use a material slide view to make data available without actual data pipeline, such as create a table. Using the preview features of merge to simplify the process of handling transactional data with upstream records. For data service insight, use data sharing to simplify the process to provide the data to different data consumer. Use the preview feature of dynamic data masking to make data available without a compromised data privacy. Here, I add several links in this slide for your reference. If you have any questions, please reach out to our account team, solution architecture team, and the professional service team. We love to help you. Happy learning and happy building with low code and less code in Redshift.